for Liz, Irritable Bowel Syndrome Awareness Month. What are the symptoms, what are the possible causes, and how do we treat it? We welcome Dr. Joseph Chang. He's a board-certified gastroenterologist at the Queens Medical Center West Oahu campus. He's also a clinical assistant professor of medicine at the John Ayburn School of Medicine. Good to have you here, Doctor.
Good morning, Ryan.
A little bit about the IBS, and it's a very popular question in our weekly segments on with Dr. Brady, but I know we have a photo of a colon. What are we seeing here, first of all?
Yeah, so this is a picture of the colon, Ron, and that's because irritable bowel syndrome is a chronic and recurring condition of the large intestine or colon. It really has two hallmark features. One of them is abdominal pain, which is often described as bloating, distension, even sharp and cramping. That pain is then associated with the other feature, which is a change in stool frequency and or consistency, which is basically saying, Ron, to make things worse, you have abdominal pain with either constipation, diarrhea, or even a mixture of both.
Mm-hmm. And that's where the discomfort comes from, and you've seen some of the causes, but you have gas pains, you have diarrhea,
correct,
like you said.
Correct.
What's causing all that?
And that's the problem with IBS, Ron. We don't know. Oh. So there's a lot of research going into what the exact mechanisms are. Some are thinking that it's a disruption in how the gut interacts with the brain and nervous system. Others are looking at the motility of the colon. Some are even looking at how the gut bacteria or even our diet plays a role in people with irritable bowel syndrome. But unfortunately, as of today, we just don't know what causes it.
So when you look at someone's colon, when you're finding treatments, and we'll get to that question in a second, do you see it? Do you see what's happening in someone's tummy?
That's the problem, is that there's no definitive one test to tell us someone has irritable bowel syndrome. So IBS is actually diagnosed clinically. We have a criteria called the Rome criteria that we use to help diagnose patients.
And when you diagnose it, you've got to treat it. What are some of the treatments?
And that's where there's exciting news to talk about today. You know, traditionally as doctors, we didn't have much. We told them to watch their diet.
Right.
If they had constipation, take a laxative. If they had diarrhea, take an anti-diarrhea medication. But recently, three new medications have actually been approved by the FDA specifically for irritable bowel syndrome. So it's even tailored towards their symptoms. So for example, if someone has more constipation, there's actually a medication called Linzess, FDA approved for constipation predominant irritable bowel syndrome. If they have more diarrhea, there's actually two medications now, one called Xifaxan, the other one called Viberzi, that have been FDA approved for diarrhea predominant irritable bowel syndrome.
Is it common?
It's very common. Yeah. It's estimated between 10 to 15% of the general population. So anywhere between 30 to 45 million people here in the United States,
wow,
suffer from IBS.
When you look at the FDA-approved medications, a lot of folks are probably asking who's been suffering and enduring,
right,
why has it taken so long? But it's exciting that this is an option now.
Absolutely. It's a really good time for people out there to connect with their health providers to really talk about these new options we have now.
Okay, if you want to learn more about irritable bowel syndrome, join Dr. Chang for the Queens Medical Center West Oahu campus. They're offering a free speaking health lecture. It happens Thursday, Doc?
Yep.
April 21st, from 6 to 7 over at the Queens West Oahu campus. Again, to register, call the Queens referral line or go to our website, kh12.com. We'll have all that information for you. I don't want to joke about it because this is a very serious subject, and anybody who's dealt with this, but I've never heard anybody say, we have exciting news about IBS. But really, it is.
It really is.
Yeah, for
it
anyone
really
who's suffered, you know that these options, these treatment options,
correct,
is good news.
It is.
Yeah, Dr. Chang, good to see you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much for your time.